I will now take leaders' questions, understanding Order 29. Deputy Micheál Martin.
Thank you, Cian Corla. Tánaiste, there have been reports in the Sunday Business Post, in particular at the weekend, in relation to leaks from the recommendations of the trauma steering group that was set up by Minister Leo Varadkar last year, essentially identifying 9 accident and emergency departments that are under threat for downgrading, shorter times, closure in some regards, and the removal of trauma from them. And the reason I raise this is because obviously concern right across the country in Cavan, Naas, Portiuncla, Mullingar, St Luke's in Kilkenny, Clonmel, Mercy Hospital in Cork, and Portlaoise General. Now, the point I would make is that in all of the emergency departments across the country, there is incredible overcrowding. Even today, there are 400 people on trolleys. It's important. There was a time, for example, when the rows were about a county. Would there be an emergency department in a county? If you look at this report, there will be regions without emergency departments if this trend continues. In other words, if you look at the east, you're looking at potentially Waterford to Dublin and nothing in between, with Kilkenny and Wexford taken out. If you look at the Midlands, you'll be looking at Tullamore right up to Tallaght and Dublin. Now, the problem is, of course, that the emergency departments in Dublin simply cannot cope. They're bursting at the seams. In Cork, we've had Salt Infirmary closed, Mallow, Bantry down through the years. The point I'm making here is there has been significant reconfiguration already. And some medics will say the politicians will oppose this and oppose that. There needs to be a re-evaluation of all of this and of the trend, because before we're finished, everybody will be going to Dublin for an emergency facility or department. So, yes, there has to be professional medical input, but there has to be balance and common sense and evaluation of what has happened already, because there is incredible overcrowding. If you look at Galway University Hospital, and I was down there myself last year, an appalling vista in terms of 2 cubicles for paediatric children there. Completely incapable of dealing what it's already been asked to deal with in terms of the reconfiguration along the western seaboard and all of Donegal and Letterkenny all having to shift people down to Galway. And it simply cannot cope. It's not even on the capital programme to 221 for the major refurbishment that it requires.
So it can't possibly cope.
So the bottom line I'm putting it to you, Minister, is there needs to be a fundamental rethink in terms of where we're going. Common sense and a bit of balance brought to the equation in terms of best outcomes. Because best outcomes also mean morbidity and fatality because of overcrowding itself. And doctors have estimated that people are dying because of overcrowding in our emergency hospitals. So will you confirm, Minister, as to when this steering group report will be published? Can you confirm that the leaks are accurate in terms of what has been revealed so far? And can you confirm that the hospitals or the A&Es concerned will not be downgraded or affected?
Thank you very much, Deputy Martin. It's very important to reassure people that the work which is underway on developing a national trauma policy is about getting the best outcomes for a particular small category of patients who sustain traumatic injuries. The Minister has not yet received that report, probably won't get it until towards the end of the year. There is no question of closing down emergency departments. In relation to the broader points that you make, attendances in our health service are up 6%. There was, for example, 13,500 more elective procedures done this year than last year. The government has just invested 90% of available resources, 500 million, into our health services to deal with the pressures that you've outlined. There's no question of focusing emergency care in Dublin. Clearly, we're establishing the hospital groups so that we have care throughout the country and appropriate care. But you do know, Deputy, there are very large demands on our health services. And again, I'd repeat, that's why 500 million extra has been invested this year and why the National Treatment Purchase Fund has been allocated 15 million to deal with those longest on our waiting list. So all of those those initiatives are targeted at dealing with improving our waiting lists, making sure that people get the service. But again, I would point out that the throughput in our health services is up. Attendances are up 6%. So there is that high demand, but the government are responding by investing further, by making sure that we have the appropriate services around the country in terms of the hospital groups having responsibility in developing local service. And I would repeat again that there is no intention to close down emergency departments. That is not the Minister's intention. This is about trauma care. How do you get patients to the best centre if they suffer a traumatic injury in an accident, in a road accident? What's the appropriate place? And the Royal College of Surgeons have been doing that work. They made the recommendation, and the Minister agreed that this area should be examined, again, in order to give the very best care to people who are suffering traumatic injury.
Martin, you have a minute.
Tánaiste, I asked about the emergency departments, not the waiting list, which I asked last week, which have got far worse, by the way, very poor indeed in terms of some of the waiting times there. But in terms of your answer, they may not be closed down, you're saying, but the nature of what happens there could very dramatically change. And the point I'm making to you is this, that there has been no re-evaluation of the trend and the model that the medics are driving incessantly without any evaluation of what has actually happened. That's my point. Because the tertiary centres cannot cope. And when will someone cop on to that? That there are huge problems now in where we centralised everything to key tertiary models, and I've been in them myself. There is no way they can cope with more report after more report without a proper overarching model being put in place. And it needs intervention. The Minister is well briefed on this. I know he hasn't got the report formally, but he has been. Look, Minister, you're nodding your head. You would have been briefed on this, and officials will have briefed you, and you should brief yourself on it, because tomorrow morning you'll be told what's in the pipeline. What happens normally. But the bottom line is someone needs to push back here and simply say, Tala is not going to be able to take everything. Galway simply can't cope with what it has at the moment, never mind closing down another facility. Cork University Hospital can't take any more. In terms of the numbers that are attending. And now they're talking about having one for the entire county and city. It's just not a doable.
Thank you very much, Deputy.
So I put to you, Minister, do you accept the need for new thinking to balance what the medics are bringing to the table with other studies and analysis of what has happened so far? You take Limerick and Ennis. I mean, politicians went along with that.
I'm sorry,
but the experience of the Limerick Acute Hospital has been very difficult and very challenging for all concerned.
Tánaiste.
Well, you're a former Minister for Health, Deputy, and you know that we do need to examine how these trauma patients are best dealt with. That's what this study is about. It's important not to raise unnecessary anxieties in people. I've outlined to you the position in relation to the emergency departments. It's not about closing emergency departments or diminishing services. And there are currently no plans to close or remove trauma services from hospital. But I would repeat to you, from hospitals, but I would repeat to you that it's extremely important to look at this very small percentage of patients and to discuss in a rational way to get the report on what is the best way to deal with people who have a particular type of trauma and where is the best place for the person with a head injury, for example, after a car accident, to go to. It may not be the nearest emergency department. It may be a specialist trauma centre. And that's what we're talking about. That's what you've raised. And you've gone on to talk about the possible closure of other departments, which isn't on the agenda. And I've repeated to you, it's not on the agenda. What is on the agenda is a discussion about the best type of care. The report hasn't been received by the Ministry yet, and when it is, it will be considered.
Thank you very much, Tánaiste.